to go in or not go in. And Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu was told the same by one of the Sahaba. Are you running from Qadrullah? He said, yes, I'm running from Qadrullah to Qadrullah. I'm running from the destiny that will afflict us if we go inside to the destiny that we choose when we don't go. He said to him a question. He said, if you had your animals that you brought to graze on a pasture, and you have one pasture that's lush and green and one doesn't have any grass. If you go there, it's Qadrullah. If you go there, it's Qadrullah. Which one do you choose? The green one. Because you want your animals to be healthy. So you choose that because, and you can choose that. Both are Qadrullah. Both are predestined. Either of them you choose Qadrullah. A person who has a skin condition, the Prophet ﷺ, Allah Ta'ala Rahman ibn Awf, and Az-Zubayr ibn Al-Awwam radiallahu anhuma, to wear silk, full silk clothing, because the men are not allowed to wear silk in Islam, the women are allowed to wear silk, and the men are allowed the limit of 4 fingers to beautify their clothes. You can beautify your clothes 4 fingers, maybe, I don't know, in inches, maybe 2 inches or something like that. In centimeters, for those of you who think metric, maybe 8 centimeters or 6 centimeters, depending on your fingers. Because can have some, mashallah, big fingers. Can put a lot of silk there. But some have small fingers like me, I can't put a lot of silk. So, that is the maximum for men, the maximum of silk allowed to be worn by men. And the person allowed for those because they have conditions that are to do with the skin and also the ulama said with lice. Not only head lice, but other types of lice that can be on the skin of the patient, and because of that it is permissible for them because silk is very good for that. It is not heavy. It is light, but at the same time it's not cold, it's warm. And this is something that is allowed as a rukhsa, as a concession. Also the Prophet ﷺ recommended, and I'm coming inshallah to sihr, but I'm coming slowly. The Prophet ﷺ recommended for the person who has headache to use henna, and that is henna. كان عليه الصلاة والسلام إذا صدع غلف رأسه بالحناء ويقول إنه نافع بإذن الله من الصداع. It's narrated in the Sunan of Ibn Majah رحمه الله and Shaykh al-Albani said it's sahih or Hassan rather, sorry, that the Prophet ﷺ, when he used to have headache, and also in Islam, in Arabic they say shaqiqa, when one of sides, shiqqul ra's, one of the sides of the head is painful. So that is generally the whole head or anywhere, migraine for example, or some part of the head is aching. And shaqiqa is one part, one side of the head. And some people say I have splitting headache, meaning it's like the head wants to explode. And that the Ibn Qayyim mentioned and other scholars that it's because many reasons, they give many reasons, 10, 20, 30 reasons. Some of them fought because of blood, that's why it's good to do hijama. But I warn you, for that you have to shave your head. You can't do on the nice haircut that you did for 20 pounds yesterday. You have to become a baldy for a while. And if you do it, you do on the top of your head. And those brothers who do hijama know it. And at the ayin, which is on the sides of the head. And believe me, some brothers, I haven't tried it yet, I've tried on some other areas, but some brothers who've tried it, they said, one of them is 36 or 37 of age. He said, I feel like I'm 20 again. I said, mashallah, I hope you don't go back with your deeds. It's just the feeling, I hope.